expect your next ride on a C train to look a little bit different than usual, especially if you take one specific car.
Art takes on many forms, and the City of Calgary Public Art Program has been advancing the field through inclusivity and broader community engagement opportunities. One example is art as social practice. Instead of just one artist determining the look and design of an artwork, with social practice, the content of the art is designed and created by community participants for the benefit of both themselves and a broader community. Recognition. Validation. Reassurance. Led by artist Dick Averns is one such project, addressing the question, how do you create a framework for mental wellness? Members of the public from all walks of life were invited to attend free half-day workshops in which collage, drawing, and text were used to foster self-expression. Participants created visual narratives to improve their own mental wellness and that of community members who were given the opportunity to view the art. Over 270 people expressed interest in attending workshops, subsequently creating almost 200 artworks. Participants were then given the opportunity to share their art at one of six community-based pop-up exhibitions, lasting between 1 day and 3 months. At the conclusion of the year-long project, 40 artworks were selected for widespread distribution on billboards, city buses and trains, and posters at transit stops. The need to improve individual and collective mental wellness became part of an emotive public conversation. A public launch was held on a city bus to showcase and celebrate the project artwork.
And so we went to this workshop, and it was exploring the role of artists as change makers. And the thing that Sean said to us after we went through the process was, I really do think you have a solution, and it's about finding the problems. And I think this is one of the solutions that Dick and all of the artists who were involved in creating the pieces that we see on the bus and on the streets and on the transit stops are doing. And you know, one of the lines that really struck me was about bringing something that's invisible, visible. For those of us who don't even sometimes see it, we don't even notice, we don't even acknowledge it, it's not even on our radar. And art has a way of getting it on our radar.
Artists have in particular been instrumental in exposing these issues, in provoking meaningful discussions and creative outcomes that connect communities, particularly through public art.
We have come to realize that art, in all its forms, can be restorative and healing to both the artists who create it and the audience that views it. This framework for mental wellness has been displayed in the artworks created for this project. We have proudly displayed the artworks in our windows along 12th Avenue to support this project and its intent, and to help generate public and community interest and thought for those who view it.
The City of Calgary's Public Art Program established Averns Initiative, having first offered a series of mentored workshops enabling six competitively selected artists to learn from leading international social practice artists. Alfredo Yar, Tanya Bergera, and Jean Van Heeswijk led three separate workshops, culminating in a month-long exhibition of proposals at the Illingworth Kerr Gallery. From this, Averns won the inaugural Social Practice Award.
What was really valuable from participating in the workshop program was building the confidence to address difficult-to-deal-with subject matter, and then translate that and create a catalyst for a wide range of community members to translate their own mental health experiences for much wider audiences.
The project curator has developed 189 pieces through workshops over the course of a year, and now they're being displayed on this C train.
One of the most important aspects with art as social practice is providing community members with a meaningful voice. Recognition, validation, reassurance achieves this through establishing wide-ranging community partnerships with 12 organizations, serving both individuals in need and people whose mental health may not be currently served.
Our collaborators included the Fresh Start Recovery Center. It's a rehab addiction treatment facility for males. We worked with Spark Disability Arts Festival, entrepreneurs out of a co-working space, and also ran a workshop for healthcare providers at the Foothills Hospital. As the lead artist, much of my motivation does stem from lived experience. I wasn't diagnosed with Tourette's syndrome until I was 41, so spent a lot of my life without being treated effectively, and now I'm able to turn that around through projects like this and work with others in the community.
What makes this project important is it brings individuals into a workshop so that they can think about their own experiences with their own mood disorders and how this can be expressed through a series of artworks or collages. And it actually normalizes the process of dealing with mental health internally and sharing that with the community.
We know that including lived experience is the best single way to reduce the stigma of mental illness. Research has borne that out in so many different ways. We know that by including lived experience, it shows that people with mental illnesses are just like you and I. Art activities such as this really hint at new ways of providing treatment for those with mental illnesses or those with mental health challenges.
With social practice as public art, we believe greater community inclusion can address real-world challenges.
I think the value also of running this as an applied research project with a research ethics board approval, informed consent documents, allowing community participants to have anonymity or use pseudonyms if they wish. It really helped instill a level of rigor in the platform that we built this program out of. And really surprisingly, 98% of participants were willing to donate their artwork and then have it viewed by strangers in pop-up exhibitions, billboards, and transit.
The 187 personalized artistic expressions of mental wellness created for this project are a testament to the positive contributions that public art and social practice can make towards collective community wellness. Recognition. Validation. Reassurance. How do you create a framework for mental wellness? Thank you.